Do you think you can actually feel the temperature of things you touch? That's hilarious. The temperature of a thing is really just a measurement of the jiggliness of the atoms and molecules that make it up. More jiggling, higher temperature. Less jiggling, lower temperature. Of course, when something's at a high temperature, it feels hot. And when something's at a low temperature, it feels cold. Right? Well, no. Here's a cool experiment you can do at home or with your friends. Place a book and something metal in your freezer. After a few hours, take them out and feel them both. You can even have your friends try to guess which one is colder. While it may seem obvious they'll be the same temperature, after all, they were both in the same freezer, you won't be able to tell just by touch. The metal will feel significantly colder than the book. And this isn't just some weird trick, it's physics. We experience the metal as colder than the book for a very real and physical phenomenon. Metal is a conductor and paper is an insulator. So the energy, or the jiggliness of the molecules in our hands, is absorbed more quickly by the metal than by the book. Even though the book and the metal are the same temperature, the metal causes the temperature of our hands to go down faster. We experience the metal as being colder because it's really the temperature of our hands that we're detecting. It's like how, technically, a mercury thermometer really only measures its own temperature, and you can only indirectly measure temperatures of other things by putting them in thermal contact. Similarly, the thermoreceptive nerves in our skin can only directly measure the temperature of the skin itself, and not of anything else. So when we touch something, we don't feel its temperature, but rather, we feel its effect on our skin, and how quickly it transfers thermal energy to or away from us. This ability to transfer thermal energy is also why a blast of steam from a boiling pot on your stove can feel a lot hotter than a blast of hot, dry air from your oven. This is because water vapor transfers more energy to your skin than air can by itself, even though the oven has a higher overall temperature. Even though people use them interchangeably, if you think about it, hot and cold are fundamentally different concepts from high temperature and low temperature. Hot really means it gives off a lot of energy, while high temperature means it has a lot of energy. And if you've ever tried fundraising, you know that just because someone has a lot of something doesn't necessarily mean they give a lot of it away. Now you have the perfect topic for the next time you're at a party. Thanks for watching this episode of Everything Science. If you like these shorter videos, be sure to let us know in the comment section below. And click here to see our whole collection of quick wits. Have a great day, and remember, there is always more to learn.